Hi guys, it's me, Dimension Battles, and I have a Halloween booster pack. So first off, I want to say happy Halloween to everyone. Hopefully you guys are having a good Halloween. And time to get into the unboxing. So first off, I forgot to put the containers in the back and also like the cards that'll be in the pack. The top part is already ripped off. In case you were wondering why, I messed up on the first try. Just ignore that, okay? Let's pretend that this is the first try for opening it up. And we're going to unbox the pack. We'll rip it open from the bottom this time. If we mess it up this time, then, well, there's no going back, okay? Here we go. Let's rip open the bottom. And time to take the cards out. There you go. Okay, good. There's no more cards in there. There's the Halloween pack. Let's look at it one more time. The Halloween card. That word Halloween's like red and orange. Pretty nice design. It feels funny to make a video again. Usually I get it first try. This is like maybe the second time I've had to re-record a video, which is surprising because I hardly ever have to do that. Not counting the battle videos. The battle videos take lots of takes, but other than that, it's pretty good. So, Headless Knight is a stage 2 rare card with 200 power and 200 defense. And once per game, when this card's destroyed, you can summon it back, but its health and power are now 100. So, I wanted to show more cards for this video because I thought it'd be fun. So, the first few you guys have already seen, but hopefully you don't mind. Let me just turn down the lights. A little bright. The next up, we have Costume Thief, a stage 1 rare card with 200 power and 200 defense. And his effect reads, target one creature on the field, and until the end of this turn, this card's name and effect become the same as that creature, which is really good, because basically it's stealing or draining its abilities, and you can see that theme kind of goes over, because, like, the costume's all over the place, like a knife with, like, a sharp blade, and, like, these scythes, like, ready to, like, attack or stab someone, you know, or kill them, and, like, these cool, like, vicious wings and wizard hat with sorcery, so they're all around, like, a scarecrow face, all around a mysterious figure, and it basically has aspects from each costume that he stole. I think that's right. Anyways, next up we have Pumpkin Dragon, a stage 3 rare with 500 power and 300 defense, and when he's destroyed, you can draw a card. I like making effects that read like only when they're destroyed they activate, because it's interesting, like it balances out. It's like, oh man, Pumpkin Dragon's gone, but then you get the card back, so it's fine in the end anyways. And, oh, I accidentally sneak peeked a card there. I like the little orange effects because it's like a little polka dot design. And I'm pretty sure it's the only grass type in the set. I mean, for the Halloween cards. Okay, I bet you're really curious what that was. We use a new type of paper to make these cards. This is me and my cousin actually drew cards for Halloween themes. So the first one's by me. We have the Swamp Monster. So we got black cards. I guess we call them shadow cards. They're just specially for Halloween. And Swamp Monster is a stage 200 power and 100 defense. His effect reads that once per game, this card can't be destroyed. So he's a dark type, and I really like the ability because, you know, if this card would be destroyed, it isn't. So it all around makes a good effect. I like the little purple details in the background. And my coloring was a little scribble-scrabble, but the pen was really, like, thin. And I thought, would it look better if I didn't color it in? Which is why we have the Redux version, which is Redux Swamp Monster. I just call him Swamp Monster, but my cousin was like, call it Redux. So, yeah, I didn't write it down, but we can call it that also. So, he's not colored in at all. It's kind of like just the silhouette. But I realized as I drew it that I drew his face the other ways. Like, this one's a three-quarter V looking to the right. Yeah, that way. And this one, oh, speaking of right, make sure to leave a like button. I actually made the like sign. Anyways, so this one's looking to the right and that one's looking to the left. So the same exact effect, same ability, but he's looking the other direction. And the next card we have is one that my cousin made. It is Candy Corn Ship, a stage 2 rare item card, and it says punch through the defense, which I think is hilarious because I told her, what does that even mean, right? So I helped her come up with effects. It's equipped to a creature and it can attack directly. So once it's equipped with it, that card can attack directly, which is why it's a rare card. And Candy Corn Ship is what the name of the card is. Wow, that was a weird sentence. I can definitely English. Anyways, I find it hilarious because I thought it would make an effect like return to the owner's hand. Maybe I'll make a card like that for the future because it like springs back. Because when I made the card Punch, if you don't remember that, all the way from set one, that was like 5 years ago now. Wow, I was so young then. Anyways, so I was making this card called Punch and I was like, should it destroy the creature or what does it do, right? So in the end, I may just destroy a creature, but I was like, maybe I should return it to the hand because like a punch, so like the spring springs it back to the hand. I think that makes sense, but I'm getting off track. Anyways, I ended up not doing that. So maybe in the future, I'll make a card that can return cards to their hand. Oh, no, that's why Springy the Magical Spring. I think he does that, hopefully. I remember I did it for a magic trick. Anyways, I like the way she drew this card because we discovered that the color doesn't look the best when it's colored in all the way, like, for Swamp Mosh. I mean, it looks fine, but she went for this, like, scribbly style because she was sketching, and I liked the way it looked. And then, like, the fire in the back of, like, the rocket boosters looked awesome, and the flame sprouting out right there. And then in the front, it's, like, breaking past the barrier or whatever. And, like, the when you're going so fast, and it's, like the design goes, like, whoop, you know, it looks really powerful. And the entire ship's made out of candy corn, which makes it even more festive and Halloween-y. Next up, the card made by me is Skull Pirate. A stage uncommon with 200 power and 200 defense. Another dark type. He has no effect, but I really like the way the gold just pops with the black background, because it definitely stands out a lot. The gold hilt of the sword swinging forward, and the blue pirate hat and the gold logo right there. And then, like, the white design with the green highlights all around came out really nice. And I like the way the green highlights were there, because I was like, well, it makes it look a little bit futuristic and more adds more detail. Like, maybe it's like a beard or like a floating abilities, I guess. I guess it's like some form of abilities, and the sword slashing forward. So yeah, a pretty nice card overall. And the very last card we have made by my cousin is Pumpkin Stack, a stage one rare. I like the way she didn't do it here, but she did it here where it's like curved around the item card or the effect area right there. I like the way that she did that. It's like stylistic. Maybe I'll start doing that soon. I never even thought of that. Oh my god, I had to catch a breath there. So much commentary because I'm re-recording this. Pumpkin Stack is a stage one rare card, and the effect says two creatures on your field and stack them. I was like, what does that mean? Another ability where it was like, just, I have no idea what that means. I thought this might confuse people because it's made future cards, which I haven't checked out the video about future. I don't mean pause, but I haven't checked out the video of future cards. Go check it out. It's pretty cool. And make sure to comment down your suggestions for the future card contests, because, yeah. Anyways, Pumpkin Stack is a stage one rare, and it says select two creatures on your field and stack them. Basically, what that means is you add their powers and defense and use the effect of the creature on top. So basically how it works is, say you have Costume Thief and Headless Knight both on the field. Well, let's use one of the new cards. You have Skull Pirate and Headless Knight both on the field. If you put it on top of each other, like if you put Skull Pirate here, you have 200 power and 400 defense, but no ability. But if you put a Headless Knight on top, then there will be ability, which is once per game is going to destroy, summon it, but its health and power are now 100. So you'll be able to come back. It's not like the future cards where if the top one's destroyed, the bottom one stays. It's not like that. It's just one creature now. So hopefully that clears things up for those of you who were a little bit confused about how the game mechanics works. It will work. Hopefully that, you know, clears up the air, I guess. Yeah, that makes sense. And I really like the funny about this card, because look at the faces of the guys on the bottom, or the pumpkins on the bottom. It's so hilarious because these people are like in pain. It's like they're crying. I still look like they're crying, but apparently your original idea was that's like the design of the pumpkin, you know, like the little whoop 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 whoop, you know what I'm talking about, the indents of the pumpkin. You guys know what I mean. Anyways, but that's what's supposed to be, looks like they're crying or angry or something. So it's the people, the pumpkins on the bottom, the ones in the middle, like, oh, they look like surprised or something. It's like the cycle, like in pain, and then like not as much excruciating pain. And on the top, there's some dude smiling really happily at the top because, you know, you're not even like in any pain at all. Like the structure of the human pyramid or the pumpkin pyramid, I guess. Yeah, it's the hierarchy. And I like the little grass patch. It's just nice. And the little brightness overall made Pumpkin Stack a really good card. It's always fun when my cousin makes cards, and all of you guys seem to really like it also. So hopefully you liked all these Halloween cards with the black border. It looks really unique, really different. Let me show all these cards right here. This will make for an epic thumbnail right here. Hopefully YouTube suggests that as the thumbnail, because that'll make a really good thumbnail. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Bye, guys.